All right, let's get started. So we know that our project name is going to be Press. So let's make a directory and name it Press. Let's change into that directory. Now you may be familiar with the get init command, but you may not know that Composer also has an init command. And when you run this command, it will actually walk you through creating a very basic composer.json config file. Now my vendor is VicGonVT, and our package name is Press. In description, let's write a description. Perfect. Author is correct, so I'm just going to hit enter. Minimum stability, let's leave that blank. In package type, leave that blank. For license, enter your appropriate license here. In my case, I'm just going to put MIT. Composer init also allows you to require dependencies interactively. Now, we're not going to do it in this way, but you can. So finally, it'll give you a preview of what we've done and hit enter to confirm. Now in PHP Storm, let's take a look at this composer.json file. So we have a name, description, license, and authors. And at this time, we have no required packages just yet. So let's get started with that. Back in the terminal, we're going to say composer require --dev orchestra --testbench. Now testbench will actually bring in the same environment that you're used to in all of your Laravel projects, and it's going to allow us to develop our package in the same manner as you would a regular Laravel application. Now I do want to go back here and I want to show you some of the packages that it pulls in. First and foremost, the Laravel framework. Another package you may be familiar are some of these Symfony components, as well as PHPUnit. So now that our installation is done, let's go ahead and initialize our Git repository. Git init, and we have an empty repository. Git status, and we have a couple of directories in here. Now you may not be used to seeing the vendor directory and something like a .idea directory, and this is because Laravel actually ships with a very nice git ignore. Now a git ignore file will actually instruct Git to ignore certain directories or files, and it does this because they're not supposed to be in version control. Things like your vendor directory, that gets created when you run Composer. And a .idea directory, in my case, that's a PHP Storm file. So that doesn't need to be inside your source control. Let's visit the Laravel GitHub page and take a look at that git ignore file. Now when we look at this file, you see we have that .idea and vendor and a couple of other directories here. So what I actually want to do is bring in this entire file into our project. I'm going to select everything. I'm going to copy it, switch back to PHP Storm, and go ahead and make a new file. New file. We're going to name this file .gitignore, and I'm simply going to paste that in. Save, git status, and there we go. Those files are done. So we're ready for our first commit. Git add period, git commit. Initial commit. Perfect. We're making great progress. The first thing we're going to talk about is directory structure. This is one of those topics that becomes a little bit complicated when you start package development because you're not sure where to put your files. But rest assured, there's an easy approach for this. And the approach that we're going to take is to simply use the exact same directory structure that we are used to in our Laravel packages. Let's go back to the Laravel GitHub page one more time and take a look at the directory structure. So we have an app, directory, bootstrap, config, routes, storage, test, and so on and so forth. We're going to follow this exact same directory structure with one exception. Instead of an app directory, we're actually going to call it SRC, which stands for source. In the package community, everybody seems to agree that the main directory should be SRC. So we're going to go with that convention. With that being said, let's head back to our terminal and make a couple of directories. Make directory SRC. And let's also make a couple of directories for our tests. So starting with the test file, and inside that, we're going to have a test feature test, and we're going to have a unit test. So back in PHP Storm, we can take a look at our test directory and our source, which at this point, of course, is empty. Now, one thing that we are not leveraging just yet is autoloading. So let's go back to our composer.json file and add a couple of entries. The first one is autoload. We're going to do this in PSR4. And the first thing we got to tell it is what our namespace is going to be. In my case, vic.vt press. And we also have to tell it where the main entry point is for that namespace. In our case, the SRC directory. We're also going to autoload our tests. So to do that, we're going to add another entry, autoload-dev. Also in PSR4, and a slightly different namespace, vic.vt press tests. So where's the entry point for that? Well, that's going to be in our test directory. And that's it. At this point, we're autoloading, we have testing in place, and we're ready to start running PHPUnit. Let's try it. PHPUnit, and oh boy, that didn't go as planned, right? We're used to running PHPUnit and everything kind of just working, but PHPUnit actually has a lot of options. Now, the reason why we never see these options is because Laravel actually ships with a little file that tells PHPUnit what to do. Let's take a look at that file. Back in the GitHub repo, there's a file in here called phpunit.xml. And if we open that, we actually see all the options up here, as well as a unit test suite and a features test suite. Same as the gitignore, let's actually bring in this entire file into our project. I'm going to make a new file, and I'm going to call it phpunit.xml. phpunit is actually going to look for this file when you run phpunit. So let's go ahead and paste this in. And we can go through this file, but basically all of these are the options. Then we have our test suite sections, and then we have a filter for which files are actually going to be tested. And finally, we set up some of the environment files. We don't need these right now, so I'm actually going to erase them. And the only other thing you have to change is instead of an app directory, it's going to be our SRC directory. I'm going to hit save, switch back to iTerm, and run phpunit one more time. And there you go. The tests have been executed. One last thing I do want to do is just write a very simple test that will allow us to really test something. So I'm going to make a new PHP class, and we're going to call it initial test. My namespace is vic.vt slash press slash tests. You may be used to simply running PHP artisan make test, so you're not used to setting up your tests from scratch. But one thing you may know is that every test extends a test case. Now, in the case of Laravel, it typically extends the test case for the Laravel framework. But because we're developing a package, we actually have to extend the test case that ships with the orchestra test bench. So let's look for that now. And here it is. The full namespace is orchestra test bench test case. So we see that got imported up here. And let's write our very first simple test. Now, one thing I want you to notice here, so we have all the assertions that you're used to seeing already. So we're simply going to assert true and pass in true. And of course, that's going to pass. Let's go back to iTerm, run phpunit one more time. And there we go. We have a green test.